Hi, welcome to Eritech Solutions. So today I want to talk about interfacing with LEDs with different formations. And also I'll show you one traffic signal implementation with microcontroller. So now, before proceeding interfacing with microcontroller, so you should understand the minimum components required for your microcontroller. So across 18 and 19 pins, you need to connect crystal oscillator to generate clock cycles. So these clock cycles are used for program execution, and in series you need to connect two capacitors to filter the noise. And 9th pin also required this RC combination as reset button. So this RC combination provide time constant to the microcontroller to reset. And 31 pin I am connecting to VCC to disable external access memory. So these connections are mandatory for your microcontroller before proceeding for any interface. So it is reset circuit. Now coming to your LEDs connection with the microcontroller. So you can choose any one of the I/O port from microcontroller. There are 4 I/O ports from controller: P0, P1, P2, P3. So you can use one complete port for your 8 LEDs. So programming will become more easy for you. Otherwise, you need to handle one individual bits. So this is your complete circuit along with reset components, resistors in series, and LED anode end you have to give to resistor one end, and resistor other end you have to give with IOs. And all cathode ends of your LED is commonly connected with ground. So I'll show you different programs on these LEDs. So program 1, all LEDs on and off. So as majorly, you can deal with only two different logics from microcontroller IOs, logic 1 or logic 0. So indirectly, if you are making logic 1 in program, we are providing 5 volts positive supply to the external component, and you are assigning logic 0, you are giving ground connection. Indirectly it is sourcing and sinking concept. So whereas, see what I am writing logic for this first program, move P2, #00H. Here move is a mnemonic and P2 is the first operand, and second operand is one byte constant value, which is 00H. So 8 zeros binary format with hexadecimal equivalent is 00H, and here I am calling a call delay. So which means I want to keep these logics until some time, otherwise you cannot watch the response from LEDs. Every individual peripheral has its own response time. So remember, if you are proceeding for interfacing, first you should know about the characteristics of your external device, what you are connecting with microcontrollers. It may be motor, or it may be load, it may be LED, it may be 7 segment, any peripheral you are connecting, first know their characteristics very clearly. Right from voltage, current and response time, all these parameters are very important in interfacing. So call delay means I am redirecting to microcontroller for some execution. So within this delay subroutine, what I am writing here, I am giving maximum value for two different registers, R1 and R2. R1 with 255 and R2 is also with 255. You can write down even FFH also. First, I am decrementing R2 value until 0. The dollar represents the self loop. DJNZ, decrement jump not equal to 0. First, decrement your R2 value by 1. If it is not equal to 0, follow this label. So dollar represents self label means the same line which executes 255 times. Again, in the same next line, I am writing DJNZ R1, L1, which means decrement your R1 value by 1 and again reassign your 255 with R2. So that this execution will happen 255 into 255. So for each time, your DJNZ uses 2 mission cycles. For 1 mission cycle, it will give some time in microseconds. So that if you are executing same lines some 1000 times or 255 into 255, you will get approximately some milliseconds time delay so that you can watch response from LEDs. After delay, again what I am doing, I am assigning FFH so that you are giving all ones to the I/O pins. So this FFH also, again I am staying some time with this delay subroutine SJMP main, which is an infinite loop. So this process runs continuously. So this program for all LEDs on, all LEDs off. So if you want to test this program output, you need to use two different tools, Keil Microvision IDE to write the program, to compile the program, to create .hex file. So if you have any existing projects, please close it. Now this is the first step you need to take. Go project tab and choose the option new Microvision project. And here I'm simply writing interfacing, or I'll write down 8 LEDs interfacing. This is my project name. Give the project name and click on save. So now this is the window for choosing your microcontroller from different manufacturers. You can choose any one of these manufacturer. Keil Microvision IDE support for all different manufacturers. It is a one popular programming tool for all embedded developers. From this different manufacturers list, I am going to choose Atmel and click on plus mark. It will show the list of devices from this manufacturer, which is AT89C51. Select your controller and click on OK. And this is your startup code warning. With startup code maintains all the default values of registers, memory locations, everything. If you want to add this, you can click on yes, or else you can go with no. There is no problem with yes or no option here. So up to now, you created a project and you selected your target device for which microcontroller you are trying to write program. Now to open your text editor, go file tab and choose option new. And here I am typing the same program what you discussed previously. So move B2,00H, move B2,0FFH, so that you can watch response LEDs on and off. This is a label. I am keeping this label across, move B2,00H. Now what about delay subroutine? You need to write delay subroutine. So for delay, I am giving some random values for two different registers as maximum. First, decrement your first register value until 0 by using the self loop. Now decrement your first register value by 1 and again go back with this label L1, so that your execution will repeat 255 into 255 RET and end. This is the program what you explained on presentation. Now you need to compile this program. For compilation, you have to follow these steps. Go file tab and choose the option save. So you have to save this program with proper extension. So you can give any name for program, but extension should be .asm. So whatever the language we are using, even you can write programs in embedded C also, but you need to save this suitable language extension. For assembly language, choose .asm extension. After giving name followed by .asm extension, click on save. Now your program is saved. So this program you have to compile with respect to target. Select your target and click on plus mark. There is option source group 1. Which source file you are trying to add? So right click on it and choose the option add files to source group 1. Which program, which is 8 LEDs interfacing, but it will show you C source files default. changes to ASM source files. Now my program name is 8LEDsInterfacing.asm. Select and add and close. You can click this plus mark. You can confirm that program is added. Now go with the project tab and choose option build target. So now you got zero errors and zero warnings. If you want to see this output with simulation tool, you need to create .hex file. So for any program, you need to create .hex. For that, options is click on target 1 and right click it, options for target 1. And now you need to give it here whatever the used frequency on hardware. Type your frequency as 11.059 into, this is my connected hardware frequency, and highlight this use on chip ROM option and click on output tab and choose the option create X file. Click on OK. Now again, after doing all these steps, go with project tab and choose the option build target. So your hex file is created with the project name. Now minimize your programming window and open your simulation tool, which is Proteus. So this is also one of the popular simulation tool which helps to more engineers to do more hobby projects and understanding hardware behavior with software itself. So simulation basic definition is very clear: to check hardware results, you are using software. Now select your devices, whatever you want. Type your suitable keyword on this P symbol. Double click on it, it will come to the list. And now I am looking for LEDs. So place all your components on this design. Select and place it. So you can rotate. So this is your rotate symbol. So you can place 8 LEDs in a sequential process. So as per program, you are just giving all anode connections to IOs, and you have to give these cathode leads of LEDs with ground. So simulation, you can go without resistors, but if you are approaching real hardware, you have to compulsory add some resistance with the series LEDs. So anyway, simulation will give confidence to approach the hardware. Now select terminals mode to get it your power or ground. So select your components and design your circuit as per application. Now after designing your circuit, just double click on controller. It will ask program file path. So just click on this folder symbol and go with your option where you created your hex file. This is my 8 LEDs interfacing. Click on open and change your clock frequency as same as you created your hex file. Now play your design. So you can watch the response from LEDs all on, all off. Now for the same hardware, I want to see one more formation, the LEDs. So I'll copy this program from presentation. I'll explain the second program, one by one formation. So one by one means initially all are zeros, First time I am expecting least significant bit LED on, and later second LED, later third LED, later fourth LED. So like this I want to come up to eighth LED. Further, let's see my simple logic. Move P2 comma has 00H. So I am taking 01H with accumulator, not with port, because your rotate left operation is applicable with only accumulator from the instruction set. So that I am taking this 01 into A, not with port. And how many times I need to do this rotate left operation? 8 times. So I am taking count with R0 register. And the initial value 01, I am assigning with port 2. So that I will get first LED on. And call delay means it will wait some time to see the response from LEDs. And rotate left. Rotate left means this each bit will shift it once left side. So D7 will come into D0 position in the case of assembly language. So again DJ entered R0 comma back, which means decrement your count value by 1 and back to this move P2 comma A. Every time shift and go back to reassign the value of accumulator. So even this program output will cross check with the same hardware. I'll change only program. Further, go file tab and choose option new. So initially I'm giving zeros for port pins and accumulator with 01H and count value 8, and this initial value of A I'm giving to port 2, and I'll wait some time to see the response from LEDs, and later I'll apply rotate left operation on accumulator and decrement count value and go back. So back label I'm applying on move P2 comma A. So after rotate left operation, result remains in same accumulator. So delay as per previous program, I will copy this delay. So now again you need to save this new program. I am saving with 1x1.asm. So now if you want to execute this present program with the same project name, you need to remove this previous file and add your new program. So what is my new program here? 1x1. Add and close. So I got syntax error. I am not giving comma between two operands. So if you do any modifications, save and build. But X file name is common. Now see the response from 8 LEDs. The path is already given there. So you can watch this 1x1 formation from 8 LEDs. So if you want to repeat, you can get it here in finite loop. If you do any modifications, save and build. Now play your design. Now you can cross check your output for 1x1. This will run continuously. And again, I want to show you one more program with the same hardware, which is fountain shape. This is one quite interesting program. Fountain shape means, so first I have to make it one, the LSB bit, and later don't turn off the least significant bit, you have to turn on the second one. And in the next step, third LED, three LEDs on. Next step, 4 LEDs on. Next step, 5 LEDs on. So like this, after coming up to 8 LEDs, you have to go back with the same sequence, 8th LED off and remaining 7 LEDs on. Next 8th and 7th off and 6th 6 LEDs on. Next 8, 7, 6 LEDs off, 5 LEDs on. So like this you have to come back to your original state. Wherever you are starting and you are going up to maximum and you are coming back to 1. So this is where you can watch these kind of formations from LEDs in decoration systems. So most of the simple decoration systems, we can watch this kind of formation from LEDs. Further, let's see my logic. Move P2,00H so that all LEDs keeps off. And I am assigning count value 08 for this. So for this register, and I'll copy this program and I'll explain in key. I'm just replacing this previous program. Again, I'm taking new file and control V simply. So let's see this logic. I'll explain clearly line by line. So move A,01H as per same previous logic, but you are not going to clear this least significant bit. So how I am doing this logic? Simply A call delay so that the first response you will get it from LEDs. Set bit C, which means, so I am making carry logic as 1. So there is another option from instruction set, RLC, rotate left through carry. This is one option for us. You can rotate, you can do your rotate operation through carry logic. So already I made carry logic 1, and whenever you are applying rotate left through carry option, D7 logic is moved to carry state and previous carry logic is moved to least significant bit position. So that previous carry logic is 1, D7 is 0. So that you will get 2 ones from this rotate left through carry operation after. So where it is going to save? In accumulator itself. Count, decrement your count value and go back to this port. Move P2,A. So that you can watch response from LEDs, 2 LEDs on. And later, again, set bit C. So previously this became 0 because D7 logic is 0 from the hexadecimal value. So again it becomes 1. And again we are doing rotate left through carry option. So again D7 is 0 and carry logic is 1. So you will get 3 ones from the output. So this process I am repeating until 8 times. And after 8 times you will get all ones from the LEDs. But how to go back to make zeros from all ones to 00001 here? Clear your C and do rotate right operation so that your carry logic every time will become 0. And bit is moved to D7 position every time. So the existence value on accumulator you need to move to port 2. So again this operation also I'll do 8 times. So for up to here, up to once 8 times, and from all ones to 0001 8 times. So this process I am repeating 8 times here, and this process I am repeating 8 times here. Delay is common as per previous programs. So let's cross check the output of this program with Keil Microvision. So I saved this program here by taking new text and remove this file now and save this existence program first. So my program is Fountain Formation. Sorry, you have to save this program with .asm compulsory. So now let's see the output of this program. Just add with source file with source group and change it to asm. Fountain is my assembly language program. Select and add and close. So build this program. So X file name is common so that you can watch response from 8 LEDs as fountain. Let's swap this previous one and play your new program output. So let's say this fountain shape formation for your program. So this is how you can deal with LEDs with the different formations, even 4 on, 4 off, and from LSB side to MSB side, coming to on and dispatching up to from middle to ends. So all these different formations you can try with your own logics. So along with this, I'll show you one more simple application with this, which is traffic signal. So this is also one popular application. So traffic signals with three color LEDs. So you are just attaching red color, yellow color and green color. And coming to the program, so I'm just going to clear these three LEDs. So with clear P2.0, clear P2.1, clear P2.2. And initially I'm going to turn on red LED by making set bit P2.0. So this is one application to handle individual IOs. So how to handle individual bits in assembly language from IO ports? You need to use set bit and clear instructions. Set bit P2.0 to turn on your red signal so that your red LED comes to on, and wait some time. And later, how traffic signal works: red and wait some time, and red will off and yellow will on. You cannot move from red to green or green to red directly. You need to operate yellow signal in between. So turn off your red LED by using this clear instruction, clear P2.0. And set bit P2.1 means your yellow signal comes to on. But I am writing different delay program here compared to red and green signals. So yellow signal has to operate with less time delay, so that I am writing separate delay function for this, which is delay 1. So again, clear P2.1 means yellow signal off and P2.2 green signal on. So again, I will wait same time delay. How much time I am waiting for red signal, I will wait green signal also with same amount of time. And before going back from green to red, so turn off your red and go back to red signal. So this is how it repeats in a continuous process. So you can do different applications on this simple LEDs and traffic signals with this simple logics, handling your IOs, individual bits and complete port pins. So for more videos, please subscribe our channel Erotech Solutions from YouTube, and please give your valuable feedback as comment, and please like and share our videos. And we are giving individual modules training. So for all beginners and experienced people, and we are allowing to do even hardware applications with different microcontroller units, IoT applications, and in you are offering paid internships for engineering students. So please call back with this number 9676327118, and we are located near KPHP metro station, Kukatpally, Hyderabad. If you have any queries, please write email us ysnanda@eretechsolutions.com. Thanks for watching.